United States champion Chris Kanyon make his way into the ring? What about what we just saw? What about what Kurt Angle put Stone Cold Steve Austin through this past week?
Kurt Angle going someplace we've never seen Kurt Angle go before.
And the challenger weighing in at 214 pounds, Scotty Hotty.
Folks, let me ask you this. Have you ever seen Stone Cold Steve Austin in reverse? Because he got back up down.
I've never seen Stone Cold Steve Austin so unnerved. I mean, he was paranoid before, but now it seems like it's going even farther than that.
And we've seen a much darker side to Kurt Angle.
He has so much to talk about throughout the hour, including the fact that Kurt Angle once again spoiled another surprise for Stone Cold Steve Austin. But Kurt Angle got what he wanted.
Yes, and you cannot overlook the fact that Kurt Angle not only got another shot at the WWF title at Unforgiven, that Unforgiven takes place in the hometown of Kurt Angle, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. And the last time we were in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Kurt Angle won the WCW title.
I'm sure glad you've got your history down.
Well, you know me.
You know. Well, here we go, one-on-one action, Scotty Too Hotty. And Kanyon and the U.S. title will be on the line.
You have to wonder, Coach, Raw this week, will there be any repercussions for one RVD?
Well, I can tell you this much. Stone Cold Steve Austin never likes to look embarrassed in front of his followers, as I like to say, from the Alliance. But I tell you one thing, RVD, I don't know if I ever would have actually pinned Stone Cold Steve Austin if that were me.
Well, RVD capitalized on the big distraction by the big nemesis for Stone Cold Steve Austin, Kurt Angle.
How great was that? Oh, there goes Scotty Too Hotty on the outside. Oh, big right hand from Kanyon. Well, of course, we're going to have highlights from SmackDown a little bit later on. Stone Cold Steve Austin going one-on-one with Rob Van Dam. And originally, P.S., it was supposed to be to teach whoever walked through the door next a lesson to the Alliance, but I don't think that's the way it came out.
I don't think that's who Stone Cold Steve Austin expected to walk through the door either. And now Austin has to worry about his WWF title reign. Austin has been the champion since WrestleMania, and I don't think this title reign has ever been in more jeopardy.
Big right hands by Kanyon. And think about this, Stone Cold Steve Austin has said it time and time again, nothing means more to him than the World Wrestling Federation title. But now he has to worry about how much confidence do the Alliance members still have in their leader? He's got to worry about both things at the same time.
What is Kanyon doing?
Oh, Kanyon on the top rope, taking out Scotty Too Hotty. You can see that knocked the wind out of both men.
Kanyon.
Now here's a cover. Hook of the leg, two, and a kick out by Scotty Too Hotty.
Kanyon is extremely innovative with maneuvers. That was a Russian leg sweep off of the second rope.
Oh, now wait a second, where in the world is he going now? Kanyon going up again to the middle rope. He's got Scotty Too Hotty in a very precarious position, but now Scotty Too Hotty slips out. He's got Kanyon. Oh, and into a powerbomb. What a powerbomb by Scotty Too Hotty. But right now, Scotty Too Hotty doesn't have that much in him, because he's had a lot taken out of him by Kanyon.
That was a good counter by Scotty. Too bad he cannot capitalize. And I really feel that Kurt Angle will capitalize at Unforgiven and bring the WWF title back to the World Wrestling Federation.
How great would that be for the World Wrestling Federation? And how much would that hurt? How much, oh my goodness, what elevation on Kanyon by Scotty Too Hotty. How much would that hurt the Alliance, not only in the eyes of Stone Cold Steve Austin? Oh my goodness, nice bridge. Here's the cover, two, and a kick out. Right now, I feel like the confidence level with the Alliance. Oh, this big boot to the face. We could have a U.S. champion. No hook of the leg. Two, and a kick out at the last second.
Now, keep in mind, Coach, it was almost 11 months ago when Kurt Angle won his first WCW championship. So being a champion is nothing new to Kurt Angle. He's been one all his life.
Oh, now Scotty Too Hotty. Oh, the Bulldog on Kanyon, and here it comes. The crowd is getting to their feet.
Girl look like she ate one too many hot dogs.
Absolutely sets the crowd off.
And Scotty Too Hotty hot dogging a little bit too much, if you ask me.
Scotty Too Hotty should have gone for the pin there, but instead, Kanyon is off. And Kanyon's got Scotty set up for the I'm better than you. I am better than you. Hook of the leg and forget about it. Kanyon successfully defends the U.S. title. Well, folks, this past week on SmackDown, a classic rock moment.
Are you crying?
I mean, yeah,
you're crying.
Sorry, I'm such a...
Look at that. Stone Cold Steve Austin is crying.
I wasn't crying. I wasn't crying.
Austin, let me ask you something. Are you the rattlesnake or the rattlesnake? Woo! Seriously. Seriously. One more question, Austin. What the heck are you doing here?
I got what I wanted.
You did.
But you know what, Austin?
What?
You're still going in the water. Did you ever know that you're my hero?
You son of a... You stupid son of a...
What?
Come back! Stop the footage! Stop the footage!
What?
Stop the... I said enough!
P.S., it is obvious to me that Stone Cold Steve Austin is very embarrassed.
Frustrated.
Every adjective you could use, you could probably point to Stone Cold Steve Austin and use it.
Pulling contest is scheduled for one fall. Approaching the ring, representing the Alliance, weighing in at 252 pounds, Tommy Dreamer.
And Coach, you know, this all started back in SummerSlam. And now it has moved forward to Unforgiven, and Stone Cold Steve Austin is not forgiven for throwing Kurt Angle's medals in the water. And you can see this has lit a fire in a darker side. And Kurt Angle, as Tajiri is making his way to the ring, and ladies and gentlemen,
say this right now. I cannot figure out for the life of me what this is all about. What the world? Tajiri and Tori Wilson isn't exactly the combination or the couple that I envisioned Tori to be a part of. Quite frankly, I think Tori and the coach would be a good match. However,
Tori and the coach.
Yeah, I think I would be really good for her. Keep her humble. I digress, but nevertheless, Tori Wilson.
Let me tell you what I think about Tori Wilson, okay?
Well,
let me tell you what I think about women in general. Do you remember Tori Wilson when she burst on the scene here and she played Mr. McMahon?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, well, she could play and tell her story walking.
You're in a great mood today.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Well, it's Tajiri, and Tori Wilson loves what Tajiri's doing early on to Tommy Dreamer.
We got 2 great minutes for Tori Wilson.
Is that all you can go?
No, that's not what I said. That's all the time I'm going to spend.
Right now, Tajiri having to use his all of his repertoire because Tommy Dreamer, obviously, quite a bit bigger than Tajiri, but we've seen the heart of Tajiri. We know that he can hang in there with the best of them.
Glancing elbow, and we know Tajiri cannot be 100% after what he went through on Raw this past week at the hands of the Dudleys. Well, ladies and gentlemen, if you think that Stone Cold Steve Austin has seen the end of his frustration,
no, it's just beginning.
And still to come on this program.
No, we're going to show you SmackDown Stone Cold Steve Austin went one-on-one with Rob Van Dam from his very own Alliance. And Rob Van Dam didn't exactly conform, if you will, with Stone Cold Steve Austin's wishes. And you got to wonder, as you mentioned earlier, will there be any repercussions for Rob Van Dam on Raw this coming week?
I don't know. If I know Stone Cold Steve Austin, what a backbreaker. Smart maneuver by Tommy Dreamer.
Let's take a look at the face of Tori Wilson. Here's a two count and a kick out by Tajiri. She actually looks genuinely concerned for the welfare of Tajiri. I can't figure it out, but she does. Right now, Tommy Dreamer in complete control. Oh, a powerbomb. And now Tommy Dreamer has Tajiri. Here's a roll-up, hook of the leg, and a kick out by Tajiri. Obviously in a lot of pain from that back injury from Raw. Right now, Tommy Dreamer, he's got Tajiri in that bear hug. And he is attacking, like you said, very smart maneuvers to go after that back, that injured back of Tajiri.
You know, back to Stone Cold Steve Austin. If I know Stone Cold Steve Austin, he's saying to himself, I had RVD, and I would have beaten RVD, and I don't know that I can argue that point, had it not been for Kurt Angle.
And how smart was it for Kurt Angle to play his music and not come out? Oh, my goodness, Tajiri nailing Tommy Dreamer.
Tajiri may have bought some time there.
Right in the kisser. But Kurt Angle always seems to be one step ahead right now. Stone Cold Steve Austin, what a maneuver. No hook of the leg, still holding that back. You can see he's in a lot of pain. Tajiri, I'm talking about. And Torrey Wilson feeling his pain at ringside. Oh, Tarantula. Tajiri is hooking up Tommy Dreamer in the Tarantula. And take a look on the kisser of Tommy Dreamer. That move cannot feel good.
His face ain't good. Oh!
Oh, now Tajiri taking it to Tommy Dreamer. Tommy Dreamer's just trying to stop the bleeding.
Tommy Dreamer trying to cover up.
Oh, but now, oh, what a DDT on Tajiri.
That's got to be
Tommy Dreamer. Well, luckily for Tajiri, he rolls out, but, you know, back to Kurt Angle, seems like he's getting one step ahead of Stone Cold Steve Austin all the time. And I think after what we saw at SummerSlam, if Kurt Angle can stay one step ahead of Stone Cold Steve Austin, he will leave Pittsburgh as the new World Wrestling Federation champion.
What is Torrey doing?
I have no idea. I don't know.
Oh,
I don't know. But Tajiri just about knocked the head off of Tommy Dreamer, and there it is. Forget about it. She's very, very seductive.
She's very distracting.
Well, Tajiri victorious, but it was a hard physical contest.
You know, we've never really seen any true affection out of these two. No, she did.
Yes, she did.
No, she did not. Tajiri.
What in the wide, wide world of sports is going on around here? Not again.
Better watch it. One thing leads to another.
Oh, I got to take a break. Chagrin of Stone Cold Steve Austin defeating their leader on SmackDown with a little distracted from Kurt Angle. Stone Cold's got to be just absolutely hacked off.
Stone Cold Steve Austin asked for it. Stone Cold Steve Austin is getting it from Kurt Angle. But Kurt Angle, I would advise you to beware.
Couldn't agree more. Well, this should be a very interesting one-on-one contest here on E! Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Yeah.
I'm following you.
Okay.
I'm with you.
All right. Let me ask you something.
What?
Right now, you know I've got a heart.
It's misplaced a lot. Yeah, where is it? Where is it half the time?
What the hell does Molly Holly see in Spike Dudley?
I don't know.
I mean, look at him. He looks like, you know, somebody threw up and he was born.
P.S. Now, you know, I don't know the last time you looked in the mirror. However,
come on, look at him. What's the last time he got it?
You've got a beautiful wife.
Yeah, but look, what was the last time he got any sun?
P.S. Come on,
man,
come on.
Seriously,
now
I'm begging.
You should be the last person.
Tanning
bed. All right, I got you. Well,
beach.
Anyway,
how about outside before the sun goes down? Something.
Right now, Spike Dudley said to go one-on-one against Chuck Palumbo, and to say this is a physical mismatch would be an understatement.
I will say one thing about Spike Dudley. He thinks he's 7 foot 500 pounds.
You can't measure heart. And like you said, you don't even know where yours is half the time. We always know where Spike Dudley's heart is. Oh, big elbow to the face of Spike Dudley by the very physically intimidating Chuck Palumbo.
You know what makes Spike Dudley look good, though?
What?
That referee, Jimmy Corderas. That is an ugly, ugly man.
Will you stop?
Can you imagine what his mother looks like?
Throwing Spike Dudley like a rag doll on the outside. And Spike Dudley just taking all kinds of punishment. And you can see the concern on the face of Molly Holly at ringside.
Look at the face on that referee. It could make an onion cry.
You know, sometimes you are absolutely too much. I have no idea what goes through your mind each and every week.
I don't have any friends.
I know you don't. I'm about as close to a friend as you've got. And so then you really have none.
Right.
I asked you somewhere deep down, just like where your heart is, somewhere deep down you've got a heart. I do like you a little bit.
See, I treat people all the same. I hate every one of them.
Way too much. Well, right now, Spike Dudley and Chuck Palumbo. Oh, nice belly to belly. And you can see the anguish on Spike Dudley's face, taking a beating, but grabbing onto the ropes. And sometimes you wonder with the beating that Spike Dudley takes, if maybe he wouldn't be better served just to take a pin so he wouldn't get so hurt all the time.
Well, that's true, or maybe some plastic surgery to change that face.
Oh, and now a headbutt where the sun don't shine on Chuck Palumbo. Nice sunset flip, but can he get the big man down? And he does. Here's a roll. This would absolutely be an upset, in my opinion, but Chuck Palumbo kicks out.
You know, Spike Dudley, seriously, at 150 pounds, probably uses his weight as great as anybody in the industry right now.
You know, real quick, talking about Unforgiven, also said this past week, The Rock will take on Shane McMahon and Booker T in a handicap match, and the WCW title, PS, is going to be on the line at Unforgiven.
Yeah, that's not really fair, is it?
Well, it you know, Shane McMahon can do whatever he wants. Also, Edge and Christian will go one-on-one. Here's a cover, two, and forget about it. Edge and Christian one-on-one at Unforgiven as well. The Intercontinental title on the line, but that one's all about feuds. It's not about the title. Although Christian wants gold more than anybody. We'll talk about it all next week. We're only 2 weeks away from Unforgiven. Chuck Palumbo, big win here on Heat for Michael P.S. Hayes. I am the coach. See you next week. Peace.
Away with you, vile beggar.